Well, good morning today. This video blog is for Wednesday, April 6th. And so we are still in the book of Romans, and this is a potent portion of scripture and an incredible chapter of promise. Romans chapter 8 is absolutely brilliant, and it's so multifaceted and so deep. You've got to meditate, really. I mean, this video blog is simply scratching the surface and wanting to provoke a hunger in you to go deeper in the Word of God. I hope you enjoy it today. Romans 8, verse 26, and we touched on the first line yesterday. It says, "And the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness." And we're going to continue on a couple verses, three verses today. For example, we don't know what God wants us to pray for. You ever been in that situation before where you're like, "God, I sure would like to pray, but I prayed through my list, and I prayed for my family, and I prayed for myself, and I prayed for my finances, and I prayed for my ministry, and I prayed for, you know, I don't know what else to pray for, Lord. I really want more of you. How do I pray?" The Bible says the Holy Spirit helps us when we don't know what to pray for. This is how. "But the Holy Spirit prays for us with groanings that cannot be expressed in words." So, you know, I don't know if you've ever had a time of deep hunger. I know I have. Where a deep hunger for the Lord and wanting to pray, and it's like the Holy Spirit is it's like He's groaning inside of you. This is what I would call deep agonizing prayer sometimes. It's deep intercession. It's deep prayer. Sometimes you just go, "Oh," or whatever, however you would groan before the Lord. And the Lord will pray through you. And it sounds, in our North American, you know, logical mindset sometimes, or way of thinking, we don't maybe understand that. But if you look at around the world where the churches are really growing, this is how they pray. Because they get to the point that they're just not praying for their own needs. Now they're working with the Holy Spirit, and it's groaning prayer. It's deep prayer. It's deep travailing prayer that sets a foundation for the kingdom of God to advance. And this is a verse, I believe, the church in North America has not a lot. I haven't heard this teaching. Only once have I heard it in the North American church, and that was from a South African minister by the name of Cobus van Rensburg, taught and divulged on these scriptures and just brought them out. And so, when we don't know what to pray for, we come to the end of our list, the end of ourselves, the end of our lives, and now we're going to extend the kingdom through our prayer. Now, it's deep. Now, it's, we don't know what we should pray for as we ought to pray, but the Holy Spirit groans in us. So the Holy Spirit will come in your shandarakiyatia, rababakiyarabasoto. Ooh, Lord. And you feel that glory. And I feel the glory of God right now in me. The Holy Spirit will begin to groan and begin to, you'll be praying in tongues. Sometimes you get to a point where you feel the heart of God in you so strong, and the brokenness of the Lord for souls and for people, that you don't even know what to pray. And this is where we need to get. This is where we need to get to, you know, beyond our lists and our petitions. We need to get to a place where we're working with the Holy Spirit in prayer, and God. And look at what happens when we pray without words. The Holy Spirit prays for us with groanings that cannot be expressed in words. So this is not in a language. This is not even in tongues. This is not praying in tongues necessarily. I believe it's something like it. But this is a deep place of praying in the Holy Spirit. Sometimes I've been praying in tongues. Ooh, and I just start groaning in the Spirit. And there's a release of the power of God. Look what happens. And the Father, who knows all hearts, knows what the Spirit is saying. I'm going to stop right here, because this is some deep stuff. Sometimes I think some of your minds are trying to process this. You know, this sounds, I've never heard this in church before. And oftentimes when we haven't heard things, we think, you know, they're cultish or they're this or that. But this is black and white letters. This is right in the Bible. If you read accounts of revival and accounts where the Spirit of God was poured out, you'll see every man of God who had power in their ministry prayed like this. I think you'd be hard to find to press. I'm not talking about someone with a big church. or someone with, I'm talking about men and women who do miracles. Men and women who have power in their lives. Not a teaching gift where they attract lots of people, but they've cultivated the anointing of the Holy Spirit to do the works of Jesus in truth. They will have this ministry. Even Jesus groaned when he raised Lazarus. He groaned like a war horse. I mean, he let something out of him. He sighed. That word sighed. And we can't get into that right now. But I'm telling you, we need to get back to prayer like this. We're going to talk about it. And I want to teach on this for tomorrow's blog. And we'll get into that. God bless you. And, I encourage you to read this. I'm reading in the New Living Translation. But if you want a fuller understanding, read in the Amplified Version or the New King James or, one of those more literal translations. God bless you, and we will see you again tomorrow. Have a great day.